guess I'll never be the man in the expensive shoes. Now maybe every fight presents a new way to lose. And I will never walk around in your expensive shoes. But there's a wind that blows every time you light up your cigarette. There must be someone looking out for you. But if you don't know how lucky you are, maybe you just never will do.
Continue 263 miles.
Chasing something, but it's quicker than you. I guess that everybody does it, and heaven knows I do. So maybe every lover has a taste for the blue. Maybe I'll never walk a mile in your expensive shoe. But there's a wind that blows every time you light up your cigarette. There must be someone looking out for you.
One of our shows with Mr. David Ford. He's a wonderful chap. He gets his number, I think, the 11th show in the last 2 weeks we've done together. I think he's starting to like me.
I want you to be with something hidden.
So the character in the story is trying to get to Liverpool, like to seek his fame and fortune, the birthplace of the Beatles. It's all about rock and roll and ambition. And then the thing is, when he gets there, he finds that all he is in Liverpool. So imagine from Austin, Texas, you walk to Detroit, Michigan.
God knows my butt's so big,
you're into Motown and you want to go there, so you walk, or you hitch a ride, or you jump on the back of one of those slow freight trains heading north, and you go through hell and high water to get to Michigan, and then you find your way to Detroit, and then you find at the end of it, it's fucking Detroit.
It's just the most fantastic fireplace.
And this is the dressing room.
Yeah.
So we never had that rapture that they were all talking about. Or maybe we did have the rapture and none of us made the cut.
Laying on down, what else can you throw at me? I haven't heard before.
Maybe judgment was just a lot lighter than we were expecting. Yeah, maybe in actual fact, you know, it was just when some guy says to you, you should maybe lose a bit of weight. That was judgment. And everyone was imagining it was going to be fire and brimstone. Actually, it's just, you know, just like judgmentalism.
I've only got a couple more songs for you, and then I must forewarn you now, one thing that will not be happening, we will not be entering into the indignity of the encore process.
There's no kind of like wings here, so I don't even get to use the wings, but generally what happens is this, you kind of like, yeah, last song, thank you very much and good night, and then you kind of step, you imagine this is off the stage, you just kind of stand here.
Well, this is no life, but it's the life that I I choose. And it's not exactly lucrative, but I guess it'll do. So work real hard and someday you'll get yours. And I sincerely apologize for all the trouble that I've caused. But there's a wind that blows.
Texas. It's late. It's about 100 degrees. Yeah. It's been a long tour. I've had a very fine time. I've been very surprised to come back to America and find that anybody remembers who the hell I am. By the time the summer sickness and drives in my world. And by the time the summer sickness and
traveled great distances to be here this evening.
Yeah.
From Tennessee, from Oklahoma, and indeed from the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. You can always tell the Brits because they're not the ones who go, woo! Yes.
Probably good.
Yes, indeed. God save the Queen.
Steven, visitors came unexpectedly late yesterday. I opened the door to a man and a woman. I wonder what they'd come here to say. Well, I've never seen any darkness so deep as the moment when I clicked off the light.
We've met some very fine people, met a few strange people, and John has been particularly good company. So all things considered, I feel I'm in a position to declare it has been a roaring success. So anyone who thinks otherwise, I will fight you.
Yeah.
So here's the story. Like 6 years ago, I started being a musician, a proper musician. And I would, I say a proper musician, what I would do is I would fill my car with musical instruments and loved ones, and I would travel around the country, my home country in England, and I would sing songs to anyone who would listen. I would sleep on people's floors, I'd get paid nothing. And I, hand on heart, it was the happiest time of my entire life.
Well, the day cast down lengthy shadows on unfamiliar towns, and I drove 300 miles from the place I call home, and I tip my hat to the angel of the north. And the sun, it set fire to the heavens on the hills over Sheffield tonight, and I will sail over this countryside with new friends and old, and we are nowhere, but man, we're all right. So you can keep your belief in whatever.
So let's come together and help me wonders.
And I'll wear my cynicism like a tattoo. And while poets try to engineer definitions of love, all you know that all I can think of is you. I don't lightly use words like forever.
You know, rich people in tall buildings who run record labels may have thrown money at my feet and told me that I was going to become a big star, and they can all frankly go fuck themselves, because there's nothing will ever compare to the feeling of just filling your car full of shit and driving around and singing songs to people.
Now I know someday this all will be over, and it's hard to say what most will I miss. Just give me one way to spend my last moments alive, and I choose this, 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 I choose this. Yeah, I choose.